Blazers have a very brash, aggressive kind of lineup. They're going to be looking for a bloodbath here. Four Acres, if they could still say, you know, cool and collect. They scout him out here, and they will. Immediate snowball. They charge on in. Valleys, what are you going to do about it? Not a whole lot. Trixie, though, might level up the cogs and keep them at bay, but the orb flies through from Apple Ninja, and he will be the one who... oil into a tombstone. You either run and you get snapped with a stun, or you risk staying and fight in the midst of a horrid undead army. I think the team fight from HR is something not to scoff at, but hold on. Dread
is in
preemptive blast.
A world of hurt here.
He's done for.
That was a 4-on-1 for just the THD. He does drop the macro pyre, and there will be support on the way. Nemphy, he's going to try to TP home. Will he make it out? Yes, sir. No way to interrupt it, and a good heads-up play as both the Rupture as well as the Blood Rite came out just for him. We'll see how the rest of this fight breaks out. Boogie on the backside. Orb will get jaunted too. Snowball hits him in the face. That'll make it a 1-for-1. Now Volix, he'll just TP home, or at least try to. Dream Coil interrupts it, and that secures another kill. Both supports for 4ASC dead in the grave, and now Matumba Man. It's four heroes diving his tower to come get him. He's only level 5, so close to that sweet 6, but can't put down a Remnant to hop out, and he dies. So HR finding a great trade in the bottom lane.
Already getting a dish of huge harassment if they can withstand that first blast of aggression coming up from HR, and a mech could help that. Maybe they can look to turn things around thereafter.
Yeah.
But look at this. Smoke already on the move. HR looking to converge. Valix from behind thinks he got the safe blast, but uh-oh, Trouble's right there behind. They're trying to make it go on Dread, but this trap has been sprung, and Valix is going to get hit with the coil. Tries to go for the snap, but he's not going to be going anywhere. He's soon to drop, and well, they are also going to be looking to take down potentially the Shadow Fiend. Orb flies out, God Ant can go down to Matumba Man. No, he's going to make it away just fine, and then with that, they get Shadow Fiend. Oh, this is a continued disaster, unfortunately, for the Four Acres. Oh, a Rupture to fly, Matumba Man goes down, 3-12.
They're getting low, though. Is there any way the Four Acres can turn this around? Boogie with a stun, they're all on such low HP. Trixie also low, despite a little ring around the Rosie. Now Volix back in, trying to queue up the blast. Gets a kill onto the Jakiro. And the puck ends up falling. Buyback from Afa Ninja. Why did he
here?
Look at this warding,
blast
too.
Coming out.
Yeah,
super
aggressive.
They're just making sure they have vision all over the place. Yep. And
this
exactly
is dire vision we're looking at here, folks. And it extends all the way into the base where Volix is safe at the tier 3. This is a very key bit of vision for a fight in this kind of an area.
That Dagon already being shown off here. Gets a quick snipe on the Matumba Man. A couple of blasts do fly out. Wounds them quite a bit here. And they're just going to decide to step out. Or not. Apple Ninja cancels his TP. He's got no mana to work with.
Oh, but Trixie gets the kill on the Bloodseeker with the Blade Mail. Beautifully done as the Blood Rite connects on him. Smart TP in as RMN throws the Walrus Punch out onto Boogie. On the other side of it, Afa Ninja is going deep. It's a multiple little skirmishes here as Afa Ninja tries to finish off Volix. May just be able to do it. Face shifts the Blinding Light, but does get the kill in rather deep. We'll check the other side of it here as they've already killed the Tusk. Trixie found the kill there. The rest of HR on the back foot. Yeah, he was pretty dead. Did that Blinding Light actually hit the puck, or did he face shift it again? I said no because I thought he was Blinding Lighted. I was like, yeah, I think you should just roll the dice on that one. The tether is definitely going to break you. Yeah, puck is a pretty high chance to miss there. But regardless, it will be a successful kill for HR. They will dive this tower. Hook shot from Trixie. Punishes the Tusk that goes in just a little bit too deep. Now Trixie gets the Blade Mail off. They do a lot of damage to him, but he returns some BKB from the Bloodseeker. We'll keep him safe. The puck gets picked off around the side, though. That's an unstoppable streak ended. They'll lose their Earthshaker. And the Shadow Fiend, he got a tier 1 tower up top. He's not in this fight. He's just split pushing.
You know, sleight of fists, this is not going to be an easy base to breach.
Yep, man. This Shadow Fiend is getting big and bad. He's got his core kit now. Hold that thought, though. It's got him. Walks into the wrong place at the wrong time. Searing Chain set up for a nice Requiem of Souls. Brings got him low. Glimmer Cape will keep him alive for now. On the other side of it, Afa Ninja hops in, bursts down the Earthshaker before he can do anything, but the Tusk will die simultaneously after getting out the Walrus Punch. Now Nemphy without a BKB. Dream Coil. Out comes the Blood Rite. Nemphy will fall. The Death Requiem does next to nothing. It's a 1-for-2 already as 4ASC try to retreat. Coddle, he'll try to TP home, but we'll get interrupted by the Yules. Trixie able to force staff back to safety. Another disastrous fight for 4ASC will yield a 3-for-1 exchange, and HR once again coming out on top.
Something happened.
Yep. I feel like HR 100% needed a mech this game, but you have two pretty good mech carriers. Both Undying and Jakiro are pretty good with that item here. Oh, up top, Boogie getting juiced by the puck, but mech from Nemphy, that'll keep him alive. Can he actually live here? The slam, they'll keep having NJ stunlock, but no! The Shaker still falls. Nemphy does end the streak. That's huge. Meanwhile, on the other side, oh, it's HR coming out big on this fight. They get the clockwork to get things started, but now Big Bad Nemphy's here. BKB, no Requiem, but he'll start lobbing those auto attacks. Dread will not live. Ray spins him off. RNM gets isolated in the coffin corner. He gets killed as well. The tombstone comes down, but doesn't even matter at this point. Volix will fall to just a noob. He does still have the Aegis of the Immortal. Nemphy finally finishes it off. Now we see the power of that tombstone. The undying zombies keeping Nemphy super slow. Trouble, and this could be the beginning of it here. Got him. Gets initiated on by Matumba Man. Tombstone will come out, and he'll just retreat. So it's a little love tap, but I think 4ASC are kind of on the cusp. They've kept this pretty plateaued. Ember Spirit very close to his second Battle Fury, just 300 gold away. He's going Valix to become difficult to deal with. Dead. Valix, well, he's still easy to deal with, but that hurts.
Yeah, that was a maybe wonderful ice shard from Roman, by the way, that got him trapped in that kind of odd situation. Yeah. Now they move forward, they get a Yules and an Ice Pass setup. They're going to get Trixie as well. They're not going to have a high ground defense if you're trying to fight without a buyback, but Nemphy jumps in, gets the kill onto Roman with that Requiem, but now he's going to get bashed up, knocked down from the ice path. The Talaman trying to help out with the sleight of fist. Dread barely edging away with his life. Look at this. He can't.
With that battery assault, as RMN tries to TP home, but Trixie could get turned around on. Now comes the macro pyre from Dread, but it's Matumba Man. Hook shot back to his friend. Trixie barely lives. Now Matumba Man isolated, but Nemphy sets up a huge Requiem. Big damage after the fissure comes out. Matumba Man hexed. He took the Dagon, but will still live. The heal from Cottle. It's daytime. Puck and Undying now in the grave. It's a bad fight for the Dire side. Sure, they'll get consolation kill on the Embers, or pardon me, on the Earthshaker and the Shadow Fiend, but it's gonna cost them their whole damn team. All five of HR headed right back to the grave from whence they came. The gem is on the ground, and 4ASC finally get the big fight they've been waiting.
So they just kind of sit back and relax. This game could be going for a while. What a catch, though! It's Trixie getting a hold of Dread before he makes an escape. He locks him in place for the team to show up from the high ground. Roman, seeing if he can help out Dread. He's going to commit for the snowball. Wait for Goddamn. No, he's not going to commit with him. He might just throw his own life away here. Roman's going to be going down. A two-man drop. Oh, I don't think that was the snowball you were looking for, my friend. And now it's even going to be your Undying. Goddamn. He's going to go down. Double kill from Matumba Man. Four anchors quickly move in and grab three.
What a disaster.
It happened. Look at Roman. He snags a snipe onto the courier here. And that is a Perseverance. Plus a smoke and a TP that had been taken away. I'm not sure who that Perseverance was for.
Dread in the mid lane. Matumba Man pops the BKB and goes straight in. This is a 10-second BKB debut for just the Jakiro. And he does have a buyback, but still a 5v3 on the field. They will clear out this creep wave. And this time, split pushing for HR can be a little more difficult. Creep Equilibrium up top is in favor of 4ASC. And down bottom, it's not close enough that they can reasonably pressure the base. Jakiro probably going to be forced into a buyback here. Nemphy gets Walrus kicked back towards the base. But then the Lotus Orb comes out. And Nemphy will be just fine. Force stab back. Dream Coil onto Boogie and Nemphy. It'll get broken. Nemphy, he's stunned up forever. Boogie still caught inside of the coil. But it will be a dead Ember, dead Shadow Fiend, and Earthshaker. It's a disaster for 4ASC. They'll have some facts available, but now Pollux gets left behind, and it will be HR heading straight for the enemy base. Wow.
Fourth we go. Both teams showing they have such a strong fortification that is not going to be easy to breach. You'd have to hope that you get a big team wipe, and there is no buyback to fall back on.
Well, now we'll see some more item upgrades come about. Trix with a long hook shot up top will get hecked straight away. Boots of Travel's on the way in, but Trix just gets obliterated. A bit too ambitious with that one. Radiant PP on the way. Matumba Man as well as Nemphy here with BKBs on. Dream Coil's already been deployed. Can they actually win this man fight, though? Volix on the backside. Rupture out on the Nemphy. That'll stop him dead in his tracks. A fissure blocks out the Bloodseeker, but no! There's a little gap in the trees there. He almost makes it out, but Mana Leak stuns him and secures the kill for Matumba Man. There is a buyback available on the Bloodseeker. 4ASC are doing this though, putting their two carries in the Roche Pit. The rest of their team just spread around, possibly playing the Sacrificial Lamb role of somebody rotating in, and they'll know that this was a safe play to make. Aegis goes to the Ember Spirit.
This is just where, I don't know, I mean, wasn't it Denny who said once games get this late, it's just shit can hit the fan?
Yeah.
Nope. Justin Nuke cut out. They dusted him up. They're TPing on him to save, but you see the TPs come from the other side. And well, Nemphy, BKB, Requiem going to fly out. Doesn't catch on anyone, but Tomaman is going to go down. That Aegis, however, Crixie looking to jump on in, but they need more help. Their healer and Gottle's not here quite yet. And they get the Echo off from Boogie, but he should fall there after. Rotus and the Ghost Scepter will save him in the meantime. Trixie able to skate barely away from trouble at this point. And Roman continues to fight on forward. Afro Ninja going to be taken down from Trixie. Barely holds and lives. Nemphy now charges back to save his ally. Already a buyback from Afro Ninja at this point. Nemphy now nicely locked in place. They're going to look to wreck apart. And Justin Nuke cleans house with an Ultra. Four down all day. My. Only one buyback. This might be the end.
Or pardon me, the Ember Spirit died. He came back to life, hit by a silence, and Nemphy just clobbered. Not Nemphy, the Bloodseeker just clobbered in. I'm going crazy, man. That was insane. No buybacks of the three dead. Now this three tower will be under heavy assault. They're even trying to split push it with Gotham in the bottom lane. That's keeping Nemphy busy for now. Tier 3 tower falls. This will be at least one lane of barracks. I can't imagine it not being more. 4AS will hang on till the bitter end, but I think Hellraisers have finally done it after 66 minutes of gameplay.
That's just to finally take this series into a game 3 already. This is turning into a nice little rivalry almost in itself. Well, they get the one racks, they get the second here, and Four Acres not looking to throw in the towel quite yet, but this is looking over. It's just amazing that a game just amount of time and effort that both teams put into it just for it to end like that is just... That's Dota, no?
Well, on top of that, it's the team with the Aegis and Cheese that lost that fight. They were the aggressors there, and it seemed like they had the edge, but man, that Ember Spirit just, he did nothing with his second life. It was almost like it never happened. He came back and died nearly instantly. If he could have just gotten off one sleight of fist, that team fight's completely different. We'll see the final stand here is, oh my, nice synergy. You see the Dream Coil on the Shadow Fiend. Tusk kicks him back into the well to break the tether, and he's stunned for 5 seconds. That's a cute way to end that game. GGs are finally called as the throne is destroyed, and, well, Dakota, we're moving into a game 3 here, man.
I mean,
don't sound too excited now.
The game can almost speak for itself. It was an exhausting run. You know, fortunately for Anchors, they try to take the fight, which...